John Ossoff, the Democratic challenger in one of the two tight Georgia U.S. Senate races on Tuesday, said President Donald Trump's phone call to Georgia's Secretary of State, whose audio was released early this week, may have been illegal.
It's certainly improper and disgraceful. It's a direct attack on Georgia voters. It's a direct attack on the democratic process.
Ossoff was speaking to reporters in Atlanta as voters in the state head to polls for a runoff election that will determine control of the U.S. Senate for the next 2 years. On Monday, Trump hit the campaign trail in Georgia, where he told supporters to watch what happens.
You watch. And I have to tell you that the stakes of this election could not be higher.
As he again falsely claimed victory in the Peach State, Trump also put direct pressure on Vice President Mike Pence, who will receive the results of the state-by-state electoral college in Congress on Wednesday, to take action in his favor.
I hope that our great Vice President comes through for us. He's a great guy. Of course, if he doesn't come through, I won't like him quite as much.
For his part, President-elect Joe Biden, who also held a campaign rally in Georgia on Monday, said Republicans are finding out all power comes from the people. Biden narrowly won Georgia in the November presidential race, ending nearly three decades of Republican dominance in the state.
Politicians cannot assert, take, or seize power. Power is given, granted, by the American people alone.
Biden told supporters that if Democrats gain control of the Senate, it would mean a quick passage of larger stimulus checks for everyday Americans.
If you send John and the Reverend to Washington, those $2,000 checks will go out the door, restoring hope and decency and honor for so many people who are struggling right now.
Meanwhile, on the latest of President Trump's efforts to invalidate his election defeat in Georgia has failed after a U.S. District Judge ruled that the state certification of Biden's victory was carried out validly under state law. Democratic U.S. Senate candidate Raphael Warnock reiterated that Trump is on his way out.
Whether he knows it or not, he's on his way out the door. What concerns me is that we have two United States senators in Georgia who are aiding and abetting the effort to literally rob the people of their voices and their votes.
Warnock and Ossoff are up against Republican incumbents David Perdue and Kelly Loeffler, respectively. Democrats need to win both seats to force a 50-50 Senate split and gain control, with Vice President-elect Kamala Harris eventually casting possible tie-breaking votes. TJ Manotoc, ABS-CBN News.